You may notice that with the recent addition of DirectX 11 support, my GW Hook preset as well as the others stopped working. It's simply because GW Hook is only meant for the DirectX 9. However, it's not end of the world. In this guide, I will show you how to install Reshade for the DirectX 11 version of the game and also how to migrate your old settings. Don't worry, it's straightforward. Installation is very simple. First, go to my website, a link is down below, and download the DirectX 11/12 crystal clear preset file. Or if you wanna use your old settings, you have to recover the preset from the current DirectX 9 installation. It's a .ini file that looks inside like this. Path to that file may vary. If you use GW Hook, it will be in addons/gwhook/presets. And for the regular reshade, it may be in the bin64 folder or inside the game main folder. If you can't find it, just open reshade.ini and look for the preset path. Now, go to the reshade.me and download the latest version. Launch the installer and click on the large rectangle that says click here to select a game and manage its reshade installation. In the next window, click on Browse and select gw264.exe in the game main folder. In the next selection, pick the option for DirectX 10/11/12. The following part might be slightly intimidating. You have to pick which effects will be installed based on the needs of your preset. If you don't get the proper ones, the preset won't change anything or it might be only partial. If you don't mind around 40 megabytes of extra space, just install everything. However, having them all might have a slight impact on the performance and loading times. The best way how to do it is to open the preset.ini file in the notepad and check which effects it contains. Their names are always in the square brackets. In the case of my preset, it's Vibrance, SMAA, Curves, Tone Map, Luma Sharpen and Levels. All of them come with a pre-selected SweetFX pack by CJ. Just select them in the next window and confirm. Now we are almost done. In the next window, click on the Edit Reshade Settings and at the first row, select the path to the preset.ini file you've downloaded or moved earlier. And finally, mark checkboxes for the performance mode and the skip tutorial. Now you can launch the game in the DirectX 11 mode and reshade should be active. If you use Launch Buddy, don't forget to select the dxgi.dll file in the account settings under injected software. Otherwise, it won't work. Now let's take a look at adjusting. In the past, I've received plenty of complaints that my preset is too dark or too sharp or too vibrant, etc. It's because you have a different screen with its own settings that will always cause some differences in the final image. But you can easily alter those values. Once you launch the game, press home on your keyboard to open reshade settings. Uncheck the performance mode in the bottom right corner and adjust values to your liking. Every change will be immediately visible on the screen. The values you are looking for are most likely gamma under tone map to adjust brightness, vibrance under vibrance to, well, you guessed it, adjust vibrance, and finally sharpening strength under Luma Sharpen to adjust sharpness. Once you are done, check the performance mode again, click on reload and close the settings with the home key. That's all I had for today, so if you enjoyed, don't forget to subscribe or leave a comment and stay tuned for next time.